Greetings to all. I am Nitin Krishnan and my thesis topic is FDDI, Footwear Design and Development Institute, Kozhikode. FDDI is playing a key role in imparting education facilitating the Indian industry by bridging the skill gap in the area of footwear, leather accessory and lifestyle product, and because of its continuous contribution towards the nation building. FDDI is a premier academic and training institution dedicated to the development and growth of the footwear and product, leather products, retail and fashion merchandise and fashion design sector. FDDI provides opportunity to a wide range of academic graduate and postgraduate courses which help in enhancing the reach and knowledge regarding the industry. The aim of this project is to design a footwear design and development institute in Ramanattukara, Kozhikode that includes the presence of green cover or open space and a healthy environment and the campus with sustainable design. And scope. The main user of the campus are the students who spend 4 to 6 years in the campus. It is thereby important to design the campus so as to provide a nurturing physical environment to the user, giving a positive environment for the user. The main scope for the project include the administrative, academic, and residential, sports and public facilities and services. These are the different degree programs and the index. This is the methodology part. After successful bagging the Indian Institute of Management and the National Institute of Technology, Kozhikode is now on the mission to pocket another premier national institute. The State Industry Department is now expected to send a proposal to the Footwear Design and Development Institute, one of the premier footwear design management institute in the world, offering to set up its campus in the city, which is at present one of the largest footwear manufacturing hub in the country with an annual turnover of 500 crores. Next, we are going to the site analysis. The site is located in Ramanattukara, Kozhikode. It is about 17 acres of land and is owned by Kinfra. Now the land is presently barren. Here the first graph shows the precipitation rate and the second shows the temperature. The site is located 600 meters away from the Kozhikode Palakkad National Highway NH28, so the accessibility is more easier. There are two ways to access the site. One is the Rishibhavan Road and the other one is the Farooq College Road. Each of them are 4 meter wide, which is very small for the heavy vehicles. Two sides are covered by residential area and the other two sides are the barren lands. So the site is flat. There is a water logging area in the center, need to level before the construction. This is the section line that through the site and this is the section. The sun path shows the southern wind, so most of the daylight is from east to west and diffuse light from the north side. The wind mainly flows to the site from north to east direction and from the south to west direction. Site is situated in an open area, so open area providing surplus light and ventilation. In topography, site is fairly plain and light slope towards the center. The soil type is laterite. The majority of the building nearby are the residential building. Site is located in the city limits and away from the traffic and noise, so the place is peaceful and green lush. The site surrounded by good and noiseless neighborhood. The next is a SWOT analysis. There are some strengths for this site. They are less noise and isolated area, sufficient area for FDDI campus, the flat site, good wind flow due to the less obstacles. Site is enough distance from the traffic. Some weaknesses are the 4 meter wide road, which is not much enough for the heavy vehicles, and the water logging at the center of the site. Now the opportunities are, development will take over the existing land use. Project can increase the land value. It would be the first footwear institute in Kerala. Next, the threat. Precaution should be taken to reduce the effect due to the upcoming building to the neighbor, like water scarcity, sewage problem, etc. Chance to form traffic jam because of 4 meter wide road, which is difficult for the large vehicles. And this is the private public zoning. And the second image shows the slope analysis, and the third is the vegetation. Now we are looking the case studies. The first case is FDDI Chennai. The campus has a site area of 15 acres and built up area of 25,000 square meter. The concept of FDDI Chennai is located near the shore of the Chembagambagam Lake, and the master plan exploits this by maximizing the view towards the lake. The buildings are designed on the principle of passive spatial design to utilizing the breeze. FDDI Chennai has two degree programs, the bachelor degree and the master degree programs. These are the some views of FDDI Chennai campus, and this is the cutting and the closing lab. This is a high-tech lab situated in FDDI, and these are the some sketches of entrance block and the auditorium and staff quarters. This is the site plan. The number 1 shows the admin block, and the number 2 is the pilot block, and 3 indicates the retail block. These 3 are the main academic block. All these academic blocks are connected, so the accessibility to these blocks are much easier. And there are residential area in the campus, which include hostel and staff quarters. This is the outdoor lobby space or the lounge. It provides an interactive seating with a green area. This is the interactive seating space in lounge. These are the arrangement of academic blocks, and this is the admin block, pilot block, retail block, and the auditorium. And the analysis parts are long corridor which leads to the different academic blocks like admin, pilot, retail blocks. The campus is divided into 2 area, academic and residential area. The zoning is done according to the public, semi-public, and private zones. This is a pilot block plan which consists of different types of labs. And this is the admin block plans. And the ground floor consists of HOD room, staff room, and the exhibition hub. And the first and second floor consist of classrooms. And third floor is for the administration and the seminar halls. This is a retail block plan. It is G+2. The ground floor is for lab, and the first and second floor is for the classrooms. And these are the features of the FDDI Chennai campus. And this is the cutting lab, and this is the closing lab. This is the library and this classroom. The next case study is FDDI Ankleshwar, Gujarat. The site area is about 10 acres with built-up area of 20,000 square meter. The concept of the campus. The concept is derived from the tradition of alchemy, which derives from the significance of Ankleshwar as the chemical town. Alchemy involves in a quest for the knowledge and wisdom. The site planning structurally follows the square circle. It is a 17th century alchemy symbol. Alchemy represents the spiritual program of humanity. The idea is significant in the academic environment of constant learning and experimentation and wisdom that the design aims to achieve. The built form tried to maintain a balance of academic recreation and hostel life through the interconnection of various elements both physically and visually. This is the entrance towards the academic block, and this is the pathway that leads to the main block, and the amphitheater is located under the pathway. All these blocks are visually connected, and they focused on the central amphitheater. And this is the site plan. The red shows the main block, which is academic and admin, and the light green shows the amphitheater with a capacity of 400 students, and the yellow shows the hostel for the 1,500 students capacity, and the brown shows the staff quarters, and the blue indicates the auditorium of 500 student capacity. The campus have mainly 2 gates. This is the gate number 1, and this is the gate number 2. This is the site plan that shows the movement pattern in the campus. The red indicates the vehicular movement through the 9 meter wide road, and the road is provided all around the campus, and the green indicates the pedestrian movement through landscape courts, through the interactive spaces, and a green area. This pedestrian walkway is given in different levels in between the central amphitheater. This path connects the whole campus block. Next shows the green spaces and walkways and the vegetation. The campus is well planned with the levels and interactive spaces in between them, so as to provide an outdoor communication with the student. Faculty-student relation is enhanced through design by providing outdoor seating and interactive spaces. The analysis is that 7-meter wide path is provided towards the academic block, so college bus can reach in the front of the college block. And the main attraction of the campus is the amphitheater. Most students are spend their free time in it. All three main blocks are aligned towards face the amphitheater. This is the main block plan. The main block consists of G+5 floors. Here a vast entrance are provided to the enter the block. This is the main entrance to the main block. And the in ground floor there are mainly reception, workshop, lecture hall, stores and placement cells are present. In first and second floor consists of classroom and different types of labs. The third floor also consists of labs, library and classrooms. In fourth floor it is fully consists of classrooms. And the top floor, it is the administration area. It consists of mainly director room, office and meeting room, etc. The analysis of all these floors of the academic blocks have sufficient amount of natural lighting and ventilation through corridors and from the open to sky. Because of a single academic block, all the departments are managed in a single block, so the number of floors are high. The next case study is IIM Bangalore. It is a school of business, have a site area of 102 acres with a build-up area of 54,000 square meter. B.B. Doshi was the architect of the campus and the concept is design aspiration Lal Bagh Garden with pavilion Fatehpur Sikri, Cascade Terrace, Billiard Hall, court for varying sizes, South Indian Temple Complex, Madurai. This is the site plan of IIM Bangalore. This is the entrance and the road diverted to two sides for the residence area and for the academic area. This is the ground floor plan, shows the academic and hostel block. When coming to the zoning, site is divided into two halves, northern for the staff housing and southern for the educational block. In orange shows the private zone, which is the residential area and the hostel block. The yellow indicates the semi-public zone. These are the educational block present. The brown shows the public zone, which is the cafeteria. Next is the activity pattern. The yellow shows the activity held in daytime, that is mainly in academic and administrative. Cafeteria and canteen are the zone where activities are held in day and night time. It indicated by the orange. Nighttime activities are generally held in the residential and hostel area. It is denoted by the brown. And these are the design element contributed from the Fatehpur Sikri to the IIM Bangalore. Analysis. The main area is a complex of courtyard linked by walkway and in internal streets, some covered open to sky. Design include high three-story corridor with the immovable vista for focal point, that was the main attraction. Varying direct and indirect sunlight coupled with solid void combination. This design offers student and faculty the ability to see and feel the natural event when inside the campus. Natural illumination is achieved due to the provision of skylight and also saves lots of electricity. Also create a dramatic effect by high lighting at a certain area. Here the provides functional and physical attributes like space, courtyard and ample provision for the plantation. IIM Bangalore is a blend of modern and traditional architecture style. Corridors of column beneath the concrete pergolas creates a rhythm of light and shadows. Next case study is NID Ahmedabad. It is an autonomous national institution for advanced training, research and service in product design, visual communication, architecture, structure planning and allied field. The area of the site is about 63,848 square meter, about 20 acres of land. NID is situated in Paldi, Ahmedabad, Gujarat. This is the site plan. This is the main entrance to the campus. Also, it has two more entrances. One for the service and other for the hostel and for the faculty residence. The blue is the academic block and these are the faculty residence and these are the hostel. The shape of the site was influenced in this way. The most of the main buildings are provided with the river view named Sabarmati River. The site is on the west bank of the river and it is sloping towards it. Hence the entire building is on stilt. Next, moving to the zoning. The vehicular movement is restricted only till the entrance of the visitors. But it is possible from residential area to academic block and vice versa. Besides, service entries are provided for the various workshop. Next image shows that The whole campus can distinctively divided into two major zones, industrial and residential zone. The main block, which consists of both academic and administration department, is placed on the eastern part facing the river. Sports facilities are in between the two blocks. Analysis are the main important attraction of NID is the view towards the Sabarmati River. Building blocks are zoned according to the public, semi-public and private zone. No formation of traffic because by providing three different entry gates for visitor service centers and for hostel and residential area. And this is the case study comparative analysis. All these case studies are zoned according to the private, semi-public and public zones. And all these are give importance to the physical and visual connectivity. Campus are given importance to the walkways and open spaces. In FTD, Chennai and Angleshwar give more importance to the amphitheater and the open spaces. All campuses are well planned with levels and interactive spaces. Another attraction of the campus are they provide more outdoor green space landscapes. All of these campuses are provided natural lighting and ventilation through corridors and from the open to sky. Fashion defines the person, likewise the fashion institute defines or represents the place where it is situated. Each FDD is built in a particular state. Does the climate-aware culture affect the design of each campus? That it can be said that they defines that place. Building is one of its kind with its vision on the concept of sustainability. The essential outcome includes site sustainability, indoor, environment quality, etc. The buildings are placed around the courtyard in response to the climate condition and as interesting interactive space. I try to implement open courtyard space for good light and ventilation, double story height long corridors with the seating spaces, stepped seating and gathering space for the interaction and the discussion. These are the design elements. Presence of a grand entrance known as Padipura. The block of the institute will be placed enclosing an area which will be the center of all activity oriented space inside the campus. Each block has a double story indoor courtyard which brings natural lighting into the pathways. I am trying to place the building blocks according to a focus point. The blocks are arranged in such a way that here are the several focusing points. The form has been evolved from basic cubic shape. A small cube is joined with a large cube which has a central courtyard space by means of a corridor space. This form a academic block. Two such blocks are perpendicular arranged and the intersecting region is another space which is the administration block. This is the zoning. The first figure shows the bubble diagram. I am taking the amphitheater as the main focus point of this campus. So all other buildings are arranged according to the amphitheater. In the second figure, it shows the orientation of building blocks and shows the entry to the site. Site is divided into two halves according to the vehicular and pedestrian movement. Vehicular movement is strictly restricted in the 1/3 of the site. And these are the physical block model. My special topic is landscape create more interactive spaces. This paper examines the architectural and landscape design strategies and the intention for green open spaces facility targeting stress alleviation for learning environments such as those of university campus in a compact urban city. Open spaces located between buildings and working as joint or surrounding environment provide a sense of direction in a campus by integrating and organizing different places and elements. They also can provide an aesthetic sense by evolving attractive surrounding and creating visual surprise. And these are the some landscape designs in college campuses. Idea for college campuses landscaping. Multi-purpose outdoor spaces, first impression, landscape for learning, color, purpose for high traffic areas. There are some landscape interactive design which implement in my design in FDD campus Kozhikode. This is the indoor race platform as interactive space in the main block. It's an application of my special topic. And seatings are provided near the walkways, pedestrian pathways, and this is a plaza area, and these are seating space and with the garden space. This is situated near the compound walls. This is the site layout. Campus mainly have three entries. This is entry one, this is number two, this is number three. The main entrance is from the Krishi Bhavan Road and the other two from the Farooq College Road. The number one indicates the main block of the campus, and the number two is the academic block, and the number three is the auditorium. And these three blocks are interconnected. The number four and the five stands for boys and girls hostel, and the six is the common mess hall for the hostelers. The number seven is the amphitheater, which is the main focus point of the entire campus. So all other buildings are oriented towards this area, and this amphitheater is the main attractive area of this campus. And the number eight is the staff quarters, and also providing badminton courts nearby. Number nine is the security cabin situated near the three entries. And number 10 is the playground. And I remembering that my special topic is landscape create more interactive spaces. There are some landscape interactive designs which implement in my design. They are the amphitheater and this plaza and the seating space and the garden space in the right side of the host block. And these are the some seating space that provided in the in compound walls. This the another seating space. Here I am provided mainly two parking slots, the maximum capacity of 80 for four-wheelers, and also provide giving parking space for the two-wheelers. Small parking slots are provided near the playground and near the staff quarters. A special parking slot is provided for the auditorium, that is for the guest parking. And the brown color indicates the pedestrian movement, and the gray shows the vehicular movement in this campus. And total plot area is 68,796 square meter, and the total build up area is 25,891 square meter. FAR is about 2.65 and the coverage is 40.99%. And this is the site plan. In this campus, mainly the entry 1 is act as the main entrance, and the exit is through the entry 2. The service purpose for canteen and the hostel, the entry 3 is used. The service road is 6 meter wide, and the main vehicular path is 8 meter wide. Vehicular movement is strictly restricted in these areas, and give more importance for the pedestrian in this area, because here the students are spend more time. Only the service path are provided. And these are the main parking for the day scholars and the parents. And these are the some seating space that provide with the landscape, and it is also my implement and design implement of my special topic. These are the seating space that used for the car drivers, the parents of students, and I also use for the students also. And this is a this is an entry towards the academy block, and this is the entry towards the main block. So students can park their vehicles and easily enter into the academy block. Or hostels can also enter through this area and through the this area. And this is the section line is named AA, A dash, which is cuts across the main block, amphitheater, and the hostel block. Here the section is the hostel block, and this is the main block, and this is the amphitheater, and this is the main entrance. This is the back, this is the seating space that provide for the hostelers, and this is the long corridor space which is 2-story height and also provide seating. So more interaction takes place here in the main block. And this is the main entrance. This is the ground floor plan of the main block. It consists of the main porch, and it leads to the main lobby space. And the lobby space consists of two water bodies which increase the aesthetic view. And this is the view of the lobby space. And this is the lift, and this is the staircase. And in the ground floor, there provide some labs named as cutting and closing labs. This lab consists of heavy machineries, which is very difficult to carry upstairs. So it placed in the ground floor. And also the ground floor consists of lecture hall, two lecture hall and the faculty room store. And this is the pathway, the lower corridor. And this path is leads towards the auditorium. And this is a walkway that which act as the corridor, also provides seating space and vegetation in a raised platform, which is a common space and it is the interactive space. It's an application of my special topic. So student not feel it's an indoor area. And this is a toilet area, and this is a placement cell and a training cell, and this is a small conference room and it's a waiting space. It's another staircase towards the top floor. And this is the canteen, and this is a kitchen area, and this is outdoor space, and this is the courtyard. This courtyard is the common space for the students during interval times. And here's the pathway leads to the academic block. This is the view of the corridor space and the seating space. It is the first floor plan of the main block. The first floor mainly consists of different types of lab, which includes the garment construction lab and the lasting lab and the finishing lab and the visual merchandising lab. And this is the computer lab and this is the IT staff room, and it is the UPS room and the server room near the computer lab. And this is the scene below area. It's the simple area, and the view is the lobby space, the ground floor, and this is the corridor on the walkway, and this is the toilet for girls and boys, and this is CAD lab, it's a resource center, and this is the library, and this is a bridge connection towards the first floor of academic block. As these are the scene below area of the ground floor seating spaces. This is a second floor plan. This floor is mainly for administration purpose. It consists of director room, conference room, vice chancellor room, office, seminar hall. This floor connects the second floor of the academic blocks through the bridge. This is the front view of the main block. And this section AA dash cuts the main blocks, and this is the section AA. This is a porch, and this is the lobby space, and this is the corridor space and lift, and in between lift and the staircase the courtyard space which is vegetated, and this is the raised platform and the seating space, the application of special topic, and this is another pathway, and this is cutting and conference room. It's the waiting area and the conference room. Next is the academic block plan. It is fully academic purpose. We can see the ground floor is which mainly consists of classrooms and labs. The labs include dyeing lab, LGAD lab, leather goods and accessory design lab, and this is a component workshop. And this is the main entrance to the academic blocks. This is facing towards the amphitheater, and this is the view of academic block from the hoster block. This is the another view of academic block, and this is the first floor of the academic block, which is mainly include classroom, and these all are the classroom space, and this is the faculty room, and this is the scene below area, which is the scene below view is the entrance area, and this is the staircase, and this the store area, this amenity, and these are the lift and two toilets for girls and boys separately. These are the courtyard space and scene below area, which is double story height, and this is the view of amphitheater. It consists only classrooms. Here the bridge connection towards the second floor of the main block. Here the view of plaza situated in front of the academic block, which is the application of my special topic. This is the plaza area. Here we can see, the student can see the view of plaza, and here see towards the amphitheater area. This is the auditorium block plan. This is the main entrance to the auditorium, and this is the entrance from the main block to the auditorium. Auditoriums have the seating capacity of 600 students. This is the stage and this is the ramp. This is the rear lobby. This is mainly for the guests and also provide two green room. In the back side of the auditorium, there are provide some seating spaces, which is the application of my special topic, the interactive area. This is a view of the backside seating space and provide a graffiti wall for the photo shoot and also provide the seating. This is the interior view of the auditorium. And the section line is cut through the B dash is the section B dash. These are the floor plans of hostel block. The hostel block consists of a capacity of 400 students and 200 for boys and 200 for girls. This is the common mess hall, and this is a boys hostel and this is a girls hostel. And also it is the common seating spaces, which is the application of a special topic. This area is more active at the evening time after the college day. Provide badminton court in the courtyard for the boys and the girls hostel. And these are the other floor plans. The first floor, the second floor and third floor, all the floors are same. And this is the backside seating space view. Here the plan of staff quarters. It consists of a small living area and a dining and a kitchen, a small bedroom and a toilet. Here the front elevation. The porch is shared by the two staff quarters. And this is the isometric view of the staff quarters cluster. And these are other views of the staff quarters blocks. Here the view of FDDA Kozhikode campus. This is the front view of the main block. And this is the lobby space in the main block. And this is the corridor space with the seating space. This is the another view of the corridor space and the raised platform with the seating. The application of my special topic, the interactive spaces. This is the view of the auditorium and this backside view of the auditorium. And these three are the views of the staff quarters. And that's all. Thank you.